that's that. And over here, we're getting into the Battle of New Orleans. We'll start with this picture right here. This is the first one. This picture started out as a project for a public building in New Orleans. It never came about, but I did a drawing of it. And I had that drawing around. I had the drawing for years. I still have the drawing. And so finally I said, you know, Schmidt, you're not getting any younger. Maybe it's about time you should do this picture. Now, I have a studio. It's a very small studio, but I have a gallery. So I painted this in the gallery. It was kind of like people would come in, actually could come in and see me paint the picture. But this is the Battle of New Orleans. Years ago, there was a movie called The Buccaneer. And it was made by Cecil B. DeMille, produced by Cecil B. DeMille. It was directed by Anthony Quinn. And the premiere was here. It was in New Orleans. It was about 1958. And, you know, when you're a kid, kids are bloodthirsty little creatures. I was obsessed with the Battle of New Orleans. And here was a movie that depicted the Battle of New Orleans, Yul Brynner's Lafitte, and Charles Boyer's Dominic Yu. Well, my mother took me to the premiere. It was at the Sanger Theater. And guess whose hand I shook? Cecil B. DeMille. He was there, right? My favorite movie director of all time. Romans, you know, all the greatest show on earth. And finally, here was this picture. The Buccaneer, and it depicts the Battle of New Orleans. Well, anyway, I was actually taller than Cecil B. DeMille. If there's any influence on my career as an artist, it's Cecil B. DeMille. I mean, that's what this is. It's really, you know, that kind of storytelling, historical storytelling. Anyway, so I said, someday I'm thinking to myself, I'm going to do a painting of the Battle of New Orleans. And this is the end result. Now, this painting is probably the most accurate picture painted of the battle. This actually shows the whole 15-minute climactic of the battle, which only lasted 2 hours. So what it depicts is General Gibbs's regiment charging charging Lieutenant Spott's battery. But it also depicts the death of Pakenham and the Highlanders obliquing across the field, with the General Jackson's headquarters, which was the McCarty House, and his line headquarters, which is the Rodriguez House. And this, of course, is the Rodriguez Canal. And this was one of the salients when in 1803, when Jefferson bought Louisiana, he sent a military commission down here to determine the defensive salience of the city of New Orleans. And they actually decided that one of the salients was the Rodriguez Canal. This was not improvised by Jackson. He already knew that this is where they were going to draw the defense, was at the Rodriguez Canal. So that's what he had it flooded, because it ran out to the river, and he flooded it. And the British had to cross a freshly plowed sugarcane field. This is the burning of the Chalmette plantation. Americans didn't want the British using this as a redoubt. And anyway, a friend of mine, Tim Pickles, who's written a book about this, New Orleans 1815, was my advisor as to the accuracy of the picture. And one day I'm working on the picture over here. He comes in, he says, I just finished this. I had just finished it. He said, the hats are wrong. Right? So I said, oh my God. So I had to change all the hats, right? He actually gave me a model, because he does reenactment costumes and stuff. And so he gave me a hat. But I mean, you have to, because, you know, in a history painting, you don't want somebody to come along and say that's wrong. I mean, people like him, he'll come in and say it's wrong. So it has to at least look right, right? Now, these two pictures on either side are sort of like the result of my doing this particular picture.